那我们今天在场的每个团队哈，要来接受供养法师，注意一下，等一下离开，自己接受供养的东西啊，我们很随喜啊，我们很，那请大家带回去啊，可以收用来成长那种第四者的那种功德啊。他假如说啊，你们那留下来，大家来跟我们那道场的相关的人员啊，跟他告知一下，把这个东西信息然后留下来，其他的呢？加个量。
大众请合掌。四成给你禅师三棒。
Lord Buddha's teacher, I am suffering in Taiwan. Today we are trying to spread this Dhamma throughout Taiwan. This is only just beginning point.If you want to promote our Buddha's dispensation, and if you want to maintain our Buddha's teaching, all you should try. You must practice Noble Eightfold Path. If you want to practice Noble Eightfold Path,You should try to understand what is Noble Eightfold Path. What is the reason? The Noble Eightfold Path is the only way for realization of Nibbana and for the attainment of Nibbana.
We today here.正在承接一个使命，一个任务，那就是要在整个台湾散播佛陀的教法。这只是起点，那我们要弘扬佛陀的教法。如果我们要维持、要弘扬佛陀的教法，那我们应当怎么尝试呢？我们要修行霸正道，我们要尝试了解什么是霸正道。这是什么原因呢？因为这个霸正道是让我们去觉悟、去体证涅槃的唯一的道路。
What is Noble Eightfold Path? There are eight practices.Number one, Samadhi, right view on, right understanding. Number two, Sammasankappa, right intention. Number three, Sammavaccha, right speech. Number four, Sammakammada, right action. Number five, Sammajiva, right livelihood. Number six, Sammavayama, right effort. Number seven, Sammasati, right mindfulness. Number eight, Sammasamadhi, right concentration. If you want to practice this Noble Eightfold Path, you must practice systematically. There are three trainings. Samadhi, right view, and Sammasankappa, right attention. These three factors are the training of wisdom, Jaya Sikha. Sammavaccha, right speech, Sammakammada, right action, and Sammajiva, right livelihood. These three factors are the training of morality, sila, sikha. Sammavayama, right effort, Sammasati, right mindfulness, and Sammasamadhi, right concentration. These three factors are the training of concentration, samadhi, sikha. All together there are three sikha, three trainings. The training of wisdom, the training of morality, and the training of concentration. If you want to practice these three trainings, you must practice systematically. Sila, morality, samadhi, concentration, and Panya, wisdom. These three trainings you must practice systematically under the guidance of a skillful teacher.
Ba Zheng Dao 是什么呢？这涵盖八个法：Sammaditti 正见、Sammasankappa 正思维，或者是翻译成正智、正思维；Sammavaccha 正语、Sammakammada 正业。Sammajiva 正命， Sammavayama 正精进， Sammasati 正念， Sammasamadhi 正定。如果你要修行大正道，有系统的修行，那你要了解它是由三学组合而成。正见正思维是属于慧学，班雅西卡；正语、正业、正命是属于戒学，西拉西卡；正精进、正念、正定，这是属于定学，萨玛里西卡。那总共有三学：慧学、戒学跟定学。如果你要修行，有系统的修行这三学，戒、定、慧，那你需要在一个善巧的导师的引导下，有系统的修学它。
这是
First, you must create undertake precepts, five precepts.8 precept, 9 precept, or 10 precept. If you are a bhikkhu, you must observe Padi Mokha has trained Padi Mokha Saura Sena. After fulfilling Sila training, you should continue to practice the training of concentration Samadhi Sikha. That is Samavayama, right effort, Samasadhi, right mindfulness, and Samasamadhi, right concentration. What is right concentration? In Mahasri Prada Sutta, Buddha explains first jhana, second jhana, third jhana, and fourth jhana are right concentration. Such type of explanation is showing the middle one. What is the meaning? There are three types of concentration: sensual sphere concentration, kamavacara samadhi, that is excess concentration, upachara samadhi, and rupavacara samadhi, that fine material concentration, that is vajana, second jhana, third jhana, and fourth jhana. Another concentration is immaterial concentration, that is the base of boundless space jhana concentration, the base of boundless consciousness jhana concentration, the base of nothingness jhana concentration, in the base of neither perception nor non-perception jhana concentration. These four types of jhana concentrations are the immaterial jhana concentrations. So altogether there are three types of concentration: excess concentration, immaterial concentration, and immaterial concentration. Among these three types of concentration, Buddha emphasize the fine material concentration. If Buddha teaches fine material concentration, we must also understand all three types of concentrations are included in this fine material concentration.
首先你必须尝试守这个五戒、八戒、九戒或者十戒，那作为一个比丘，他还要守巴蒂摩诃、萨瓦拉希拉，就是这个巴蒂摩诃的这个戒，227戒的。然后完成了有修守了这个戒过后，就可以修这个定学。 定学呢是三摩维亚摩正精经三摩萨地正念三摩萨玛地正定。那什么是正定呢？在《大念处经》里，佛陀有解释，正定就是初禅、二禅、三禅、四禅。那这种，这个是中道，这个是适当的跟这个定学的解释。那基本上呢也有三类的定，一种是欲界定，一种是进行定，一种是色界定。色界定就是初禅、二禅、三禅、四禅，然后一种是无色界定。无色界定呢就是空无边处定。 事无边处定，无所有处定，还有这个非想非非想定。那简单来说呢，基本上就是如果也可以归纳成欲界定和进行定呢，他们都可以归纳这个进行，然后还有这个色界定和无色界定。所以呢，所以在这方面呢，特别佛陀强调。 这个色界定，就是初禅到死禅。那无色界定呢，也算是能归纳在这个四禅里的，所以所有的定就涵盖了，从初禅到死禅，也可以说是涵盖了所有的定。
No, in Taiwan, there are some meditation retreats and those retreats, some teachers are teaching these jhanas according to Buddha's teaching. For example, if you want to practice anapana meditation, mindfulness of breathing meditation, you should focus on your nose feet or upper leg, or on your nose gate or upper leg. You should watch your breath. If you can concentrate more than 1 hour, 2 hours, or 3 hours, etc., very soon you will see the color of your breath. Your breath is nothing but a group of subatomic particles called kalpas.If you analyze those kalpas, in each kalpa there are 9 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, and breathing sound. Among those 9 types of materiality, in each kalpa there is color.The combination of these different types of kalpas color, you can see as a solid nimitta. Again, in those kalpas there is fire element. That fire element also produces new generation kalpas. If you analyze those kalpas in each kalpa, also in the same way, there are 8 types of materiality. Among those 8 types of materialityIn each kalpa, there is also color. Combination of those different types of kalpas, color becomes nimitta. Mind-born kalpas, nimitta is inside your body only. But that temperature-born kalpas, color is both inside your body as well as outside your body. Especially, when you are nose or upper leg, you can see this temperature-born kalpas, color.That color, before breaking down the compactness of this kalpas, you can see as a solid nimitta. That nimitta, when it becomes translucent and bright, it is called Pratibhaga nimitta counterpart sign. That counterpart sign is the object of your jhana concentration.If you practice diligently and systematically under the guidance of a skillful teacher, one day your concentration on that anapana counterpart sign will become deeper and deeper, and that then full absorption will appear. That full absorption is called jhana concentration.If you practice this jhana concentration systematically, you can add first jhana, second jhana, third jhana, and up to fourth jhana.
Now, in Taiwan, there are some禅修营的导师他们在给这个禅定的引导，比如说引导着这个安波念出入息念，学生被引导守护自己的这个鼻尖或者是鼻孔，这是口唇上端的那边的呼吸。那如果你能够安住在这个鼻尖或者是上唇的上端的呼吸，大概一个小时、两个小时乃至于三个小时，那过一阵子呢，你会看到这个呼吸的色彩。这呼吸的色彩其实也是只是有一群的色聚， 这所谓的色聚是比原子还要小的单位组合而成。这个色聚呢有九种色法，就是地、水、火、风、色、香、味、食、宿，还有这个呼吸的声音声，所以有九种色法。在每一个色聚里呢，每一个色聚里，色聚是有色彩的，那个叫做色。它当一大群的色聚组合成一起在一起的时候呢，你会看到就是那些色彩的。同时呢，在这个色聚里也有火字，这火字呢，它会产生新一代的色聚。那新一代的色聚，这种火字产生的色聚叫十劫生色法，它有八种色法：地、水、火、风、色、香、味、食、宿，它们也有这个色彩。那么这一切色彩组合而成的时候，组合成我们所看到的禅相和咪咪哒。那么说，当这些色聚如果是心所生的，就是心生色法，心生的色聚，它只在身体里产生。但是呢，另一种是这个火字所升起的色聚，就是十界生色法呢，它能够在身体里面产生，也能够在身体以外产生。所以这个在我们口唇上端或者鼻尖那边我们看到的那些色聚，是这个十界生的色法。那么当它我们看到它像禅相，当这个禅相变得很清澈晶莹的时候，我们称它为四相巴迪巴嘎尼米达四相。那么当我们能够长时间安住在这个四相的时候，那我们可以证得这个禅那的定力。那么在一个善巧的师父的引导下，我们修学这个安钵念，让我们安住在这个禅相上呢，慢慢我们会得到越来越深的定力。那这个直到后来呢，我们完全融入这个禅相。当我们心融入的时候，这种体会就是禅定的定力了，禅那的定力了。那如果你很有系统的修学这个禅那呢，那你会证得初禅、二禅、三禅和四禅。
Based on this Anapana Podhyana concentration, if you want to practice other Samatha meditations such as Dhyangasinas, Eadimas, Post-Sublime Abundance, etc., it is very good. Such a place is suitable for practicing such type of Samatha meditations because this place is very quiet.If you donate such a place, which is suitable for higher and higher meditations, your Chaitanya Bodhisattva, which donates such type of land, as a Vihara Bodhu Monastery for meditation, very, very good intention.Because this is very suitable place for meditation. If you want to practice in such a secluded place, such type of samathas, attainments, vipassanas, attainments, for sublime abundance, it is very good. As a Buddhist, we should try to understand such type of meditation subjects.You should practice diligently such type of meditation subjects in such a place. Why? These samatha jhana concentrations are nowadays very difficult to find how to practice, to find a teacher who can teach systematically such.type of samatha meditations. Now you are very lucky Now there are many teachers who will teach such type of samatha meditation subjects, especially who supply abundance, loving kindness, metta, jhana meditation, compassion, karuna jhana meditation, sympathetic joy, buddhija, jhana meditation, and equanimity jhana meditation, upakhanjana meditation. Such type of meditations are nowadays very necessary. We should have enough loving kindness to each other. Such type of loving kindness meditation is very helpful while staying together in such a place. If your metta jhana becomes very strong and powerful, that metta jhana, wholesome dhammas will also protect to you not to occur any danger. Now it is in all over the world such type of metta is necessary because there are many, many diseases, many, many problems in all over the world.
这个阿那巴那的禅定的定义，如果你要进一步的修学十种偏处印处定，或者是四种专注品，也是四无量心的修行等等，你要修学其他的益处是非常好的，是适当的。那这个地方正是适当修学这种益处这种定力的地方，这个地方很宁静。如果你布施这个地方，让这个是很适合修学更高禅定的地方，那你的 cittana 你的动机和你的那个行善的意愿是要布施这样的一个道场，是非常好的动机，非常好，因为这个地方是非常适合修禅的。如果你在这样子极静宁静的地方修学十种边注定或者四种凡住品，就是慈悲喜舍等等业处，那是非常好的。作为一个佛教徒，我们应当去了解，我们应当去修行这些禅修的业处。为什么呢？因为这个止禅定力已经是非常珍贵，而且在这个时代已经很难找到如何修学的方法，也很难找到有资格适当的导师引导你学习这样的禅法。而你很幸运在这里，现在有许多的导师都可以给你这方面的引导，你可以修学四种凡住品：慈禅、悲禅、喜禅跟舍禅，慈悲喜舍的禅定。那这是很好的，在今天这个时代，这些业处已经是非常的需要。我们之间互相对待的时候，我们需要有足够的慈心。那当我们住在一起的时候，我们对对方的那种慈爱慈心是非常有帮助的。而且呢，如果你有得到慈心的禅定，那而且那个定力很强很有力量，那它能够保护你免除很多的危险。在今天这个时代这个世界是更加需要这些慈禅悲禅喜禅跟舍禅的修行，因为这个世间现在充满着很多的压力，很多的斗争，所以这慈悲修喜舍的修行就变得特别重要了。
If you have already established your jhana concentration, then you can continue. You practice the training of wisdom, Pinya Sikha. What is the training of wisdom? Samadhi, right view, and Samasankappa, right intention. What is Samadhi? In Mahasri Dhrana Sutra, Buddha explains, Kadamacha Bhikkhavi Samadhi, Yanko Bhikkhavi Dukkhi Jnana Dukkha Sumuye Jnana, Dukkha Nirodhe Jnana, Dukkha Nirodha Gamini Yabri Vraya Jnana, Ayaho Chati Bhikkhavi Samadhi. What is the meaning? The direct knowledge of the Noble Truth of Suffering, Dukkha Sutra. The direct knowledge of the Noble Truth of the origin of suffering, Samudaya Sutra. The direct knowledge of the Noble Truth of cessation of suffering, Nirodha Sutra. And the direct knowledge of the Noble Truth of the path leading to the cessation of suffering, Dukkha Nirodha Gamini Paripada Ariya Sutra of Magga Sutra. These four types of direct knowledge is called Samadhi. What is Dukkha Sutra, the Noble Truth of Suffering? Sankhidina Vichupadane Kanda Dukkha. In brief, clinging aggregates are Dukkha Sutra, the Noble Truth of Suffering. What are five clinging aggregates? The clinging aggregate of materiality, the clinging aggregate of mental feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness. These factors of clinging aggregates are called Noble Truth of Suffering, Dukkha Sutra. What is the clinging aggregate of materiality? In Khanda Vaga Sanyuta, there is one sutta called Khanda Sutta, and that sutta Buddha already explained. Yangichi Rupa Dita Nagata Bichopana Ita Dawa Baitawa Olari Gawa Sukumawa Hinawa Panitawa Yandure Sandi Gewa Sasa Upadaniya Yaho Chati Rupu Padane Kato. Whatever materiality, past, future or present, internet or external, gross or subtle, inferior or superior, far or near, all 11 types of materiality which are tainted, which are claimed to be, is called the clinging aggregate of materiality. So 11 types of materiality are called clinging aggregate of materiality. In the same way, 11 types of feeling, 11 types of perception, 11 types of formations, and 11 types of consciousness are also respectively called the clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness. These five types of clinging aggregates are called Dukkha Sutra, the Noble Truth of Suffering. If you want to practice Vipassana systematically, number one, you should try to understand these 11 types of five clinging aggregates. Again, if we debate these five clinging aggregates, there are two types only, mentality and materiality. The clinging aggregate of materiality is materiality. The clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness are called mentality. There are only materiality and mentality. These mentality and materiality are called Dukkha Sutra, the Noble Truth of Suffering. According to Buddha's teaching, we should survey our body. Usually our body made up of subatomic particles called kalapas. If you analyze those kalapas, in each kalapa, there are at least 8 types of materiality. Water, fire, wood, color, odor, flavor, and nutritive essence. In some kalapas, together with electricity, there are 9 types of materiality. In some kalapas, together with translucent element, or heart base, or sex materiality, all together there are 10 types of materiality. We as the Buddhists should try to understand what is our body. Do you want to know about your body? You should train to your body. What is our body? This is very important. Our body is made up only, mentality and materiality. What is materiality? What is mentality? We should try to understand our body. Buddha says this is the dukkha sutta, the novice of suffering. Why? This mentality and materiality are always oppressed by rising and passing on. As soon as they rise, they perish on. As soon as they rise, they perish on very, very quickly. Is it sukha or dukkha? What do you think? As soon as they rise, they perish on. As soon as they born, they die. Is it sukha or dukkha? Yes, we should try to understand about our body. We want to try to understand about your body. Do you want? Very good. No one is a good answer.
那你可以持续的去修学这个慧学，安扬西卡。这慧学呢，在八正道里就涵盖正见跟正思维。什么是正见呢？正见在经里有记载，就是如实地直接洞察苦，这个是苦谛。如实地洞察极，就是苦因，苦的原因，那是极地。如实地洞察苦的熄灭，就是灭地。如实地洞察逃往苦的熄灭的道路，那就是道地，就是苦寂灭道失生地。也就是说，如实地洞察苦、寂、灭、道这四圣谛呢，那就是正见了。什么是苦？五取蕴是苦。在经里有记载，五取蕴是苦，就是苦谛。这五取蕴是什么？它是色、受、想、行、识。色取蕴、受取蕴、想取蕴、行取蕴和识取蕴，这五取蕴就是这个苦的圣谛。那什么是色取蕴呢？在相应部里的叫堪达苏达里，佛陀也这么解释，所有的色法，过去、现在、未来、内在、外在、粗细、优劣、远近等等，总共11种，这是色法。所以这11种色法 心就是我们所谓的摄取运。那么同样的受也是一样，以此类推，是一种受取运，是一种想取运，是一种行取运，是一种事取运。那么这是一种的色受想行识，那就是我们的五取运了。那这五种取运就是这个苦地。如果你很有系统的修学去洞察这个苦地，就是色受想行识的取运，这五种取运，那你就会发现到基本上呢，你会了解它是两大类，就是名色法，色法跟名法。色法就是这个色取运就是色法，那么受取运、想取运、行取运跟事取运就是受想行识，这是属于名法。所以回到来它就只是色法跟名法而已，就只是这个色法跟名法就形成了这个苦地。那根据佛陀的教法，我们需要去审查我们的身体，我们这个色法，因为我们的身体有许许多多的比原子还要小的单位，我们叫卡拉巴色聚组合而成，每一个色聚都有着它的成分，它里头的色法就是地水火风色香味跟食宿。有些色聚呢还有命根，那就形成第九种色法。有些色聚呢还有那些净色或者是心所依处色，依处色或者是性根色。那八种色法再加命根，再加其中一种净色或者是依处色或者是性根色，那就有十种的色法，就加其中一种就有十种色法。那我们作为佛教徒，我们需要去了知这些究竟的真相。你要不要知道？你们想不想知道呢？到底我们身体是怎么样的一个成分？如果我们知道它，我们就会发现到身体也只不过是我们所谓的这生命也只是色法跟名法而已。所以当你尝试去了解，你需要去了解，我们需要去了解他们，因为他们是属于苦地。为什么呢？当你去了解这些名色法的时候，你会发现到他们非常快速的生灭，他们被这些生灭快速生灭的现象压迫着逼迫着，他一生起就消灭了，非常的快速。那这些非常快速生灭的现象是乐的还是苦的呢？你们回答是苦。那么一生起它就消灭，它是苦的。你要不要去尝试知道呢？你们说要，尝试说这是非常好的。
Another one is this noble truth. Noble truth of the origin of suffering, Samudaya Sikha. Buddha teaches Samudaya Sikha different ways, in different ways according to the inner inclination and disposition of listener's faculty. In the Thayarana Sutta, Buddha teaches Samudaya Sikha thus, Dhamminja Bhikkhave Dukkha Samudaya Riya Sikha,Vijja Vijja Sankhara Sankhara Vijja Vijjana Vijjana Vijja Nama Rupa etc. This is Samudaya Sikha, the dependent origination. Past causes produce present effects, present causes will produce future effects. If you want to practice Vipassana, you should also try to understandsuch type of dependent origination or causal relationship between cause and effect. This is the second noble truth. These two noble truths, noble truth of suffering, dukkha, siddha, and the noble truth of the origin of suffering, soya, siddha, are the object of vipassana. These two noble truths are called formations. These formations, as soon as they arise, they perish away, so they are anicca. They are always oppressed by rising and passing away, so they are dukkha. There is no permanent entity, permanent self in them, so they are anatta, non-self. If you contemplate these formations as anicca, dukkha, and anatta, such type of contemplation is called vipassana. If you want to practice vipassana diligently according to Buddha's teaching, what you should try, what you should do? There is one sutta called Samadhi Sutta in Sutta Sayutta. In that sutta, Buddha says, Samadhi Bhikkhu Bhavita Samadhi Do Bhikkhu Bhikkhu Yata Buddha Bhajanadi Kincha Yata Buddha Bhajanadi Pita Dukhadi Yata Buddha Bhajanadi Yandukha Smuryodi Yata Buddha Bhajanadi Yandukha Nirodhadi Yata Buddha Bhajanadi Yandukha Nirodha Gavini Vrivradi Yata Buddha Bhajanadi. What does the meaning? Bhikkhus develop concentration. A bhikkhu who has concentrated mind understands the dhammas as they really are. What does he understand as it really is? He understands this is the noble truth of suffering, dukkha, siddha, as it really is. He understands as it really is, this is the noble truth of the origin of suffering, samudaya, siddha. He understands as it clearly is, this is the noble truth of the cessation of suffering, nirodha siddha. He understands as it clearly is, this is the noble truth of this practice leading to the cessation of suffering, mekkha siddha. So, in this way, Buddha teaches and siddha sayutta. Because of this reason, if you want to understand the noble truth of suffering, dukkha, siddha, that is the practicing living, and the noble truth of the origin of suffering, samudaya, siddha, that is the bhinjan origination, you should develop your concentration, especially jhana concentration. Among different types of jhana concentration, Buddha always praised poor jhana concentration. What is the reason? That poor jhana mind produced mind-born kalapas. One jhana mind moment can produce billions and billions of uncountable kalapas. Among those kalapas, in each kalapa, there is kala. Different types of kalapas kala become luminous and bright, brilliant light. This is called the light of wisdom. Again, in those kalapas, in each kalapa, there is fire element, tejo dhatu. That fire element is called temperature, udu. That temperature also produces new generations. One fire element can produce uncountable new generation kalapas. There are uncountable mind-born kalapas. In every mind-born kalapa, there is fire element, tejo. Every tejo can produce uncountable billions and billions of temperature-born kalapas. So, in those temperature-born kalapas, there is also color. That color also luminous and bright. Depending on the fourth jhana power, when your fourth jhana concentration is very deep, that very deep fourth-channel concentration can produce the strong, powerful, brilliant lights. These lights are called the light of wisdom. With the assistance of the light of wisdom, if you try to understand, especially if you practice forgiveness, meditation, system, meditation, you can see these kalapas, then these, you can analyze those kalapas with the assistance of the light of wisdom. Your mind has this power. If you do not use this power, your mind will become dull. If you use your mind systematically according to Buddha's teaching, your mind will have such type of willpower. With the assistance of that willpower, if you try four elements meditation systematically, you can see these kalapas. Now, please try. Please listen. This environment is very, very good. Very quiet, very secluded. If you can practice in such a place, these channel concentrations, and if you practice again to understand this lower truth of suffering and the lower truth of the origin of suffering, it is very good for you, very good opportunity. If you break this system and you really this vipassana, one day you may realize nibbana. That nibbana is called the noble truth of the cessation of suffering, nirodha sitta. And then your path knowledge will realize that nibbana. And that path knowledge will associate with noble eightfold path. These noble eightfold path are Supramandi noble eightfold path. They are called the noble practice leading to the cessation of suffering, dukkha, nirodha, gamini, pribada, riya, sitta. If you want to realize nibbana in this very life, such a place is a very good place. If you don't need such a place for meditators, if the meditators find meditated in this meditation hall, if they realize nibbana, this is a very good opportunity. You will be also very, very happy. You will be also very, very happy. Meditators who are also successful will be very, very happy. In our Buddha's dispensation, such a secluded place are very important for meditation practice. If you donate such a type of meditation center, this is a very good opportunity. But when donating such a meditation center, if you have already penetrated through noble truth, and then if you donate such a meditation center or meditation break, such type of meditation kutis, such type of donation will be very highest powerful donation. Why? Your virtue is very pure. Your concentration is very high. Your wisdom faculty is also very powerful. Your wisdom faculty can penetrate to noble truths. At the day, based on purification of virtue, if you wish, everything will be possible. Ejati bhikkhave cila sila vata cetam paniti visantata. Because the bhajuyas one's wish will be fulfilled because of the purity of bhaju. Why this bhaju become pure? This bhaju is surrounded by concentration in wisdom prakarati. Because of this reason, your virtue is very high and powerful. Because of the purity of your virtue, if you wish, everything is possible. If you wish to become Deva, it is also possible. If you wish to become Brahma, it is also possible. Or if you wish to become Bhikkhu or Bhikkhuni, 그리고 그때서 웃어 보세요.
什么是这个？接下来什么是这个 samudaya sajja 极地呢？就是苦因，也赖于我们内在的观照呢。我们可以佛陀在经里呢有讲到这个极地。avijja paccaya sankhara sankhara paccaya vijnana vijnana paccaya nama rupa 等等，就是无明缘、行行缘、世世缘受等等。那在这个缘起随因缘的教法里呢，佛陀讲解了过去因如何产生现在果，现在因如何产生未来果。那这里头就是那个因果关系，就是这个第二个圣地，就是即圣地，也就是苦因圣地。这个这两种圣地，四圣地的苦地跟极地，这就是我们观察的目标。这个苦地跟极地，也就是我们所谓的行，因为他们这个行呢，是一升起就熄灭了，所以它是无常的 anicca， 它一直都被这个无常压迫着，所以它是苦的 dukkha。那么在这个生灭之中，无常跟苦的真相里，没有你找不到一个永恒不变的主体，那这就是无我了 ，anatta。那如果你一直在关照这个行，就是苦地跟寂地的无常、苦跟无我，那你就是在修学这个观禅。如果你要很精进的修学观禅，你需要去了解这些苦地跟极地。在这方面呢，在相应部里又有一部经叫这定经，什么地是的那个三昧经，佛陀是这么说的，比丘们比喻定力，一个心有定力的比丘，他能够如实的了知法的真相。如实的了知什么法呢？他能够如实的了知这是苦地，他能够如实的了知这是苦因，就是极地，他能够如实的了知苦的熄灭，这是灭地，他能够如实的了知导向苦的熄灭之道，这是道地。所以他能够如实了知苦寂灭道，在佛陀在这个这个相应部里的这个真实品是怎么说的？这个苦地就是五蕴，极地就是缘起，就是你应当如何修行呢？那你需要修行，为了要得到这个体证苦寂灭道的这个禅道，这个定力，你需要修学禅定。那么佛陀在禅定初禅、二禅、三禅里呢，他特别的赞叹四禅，这是什么原因呢？那四禅的因是很强的，它能够产生很强的、很多很有力量的心生摄法，就心生的摄具，一刹那的禅定心可以升起上亿的数不尽的这个色聚。每一个色聚呢，它有着四禅的心所升起的这个色聚呢，它们有着非常明亮的光明的色，它的色法色彩是非常的明亮，所以这个呢非常明亮的光明我们称为智慧之光。而每一个色聚又有那个火字在里头，这个火字呢也能够产生许许多多的新一代的 这个设法。所以单单一刹那的一个心事，禅定的心事，就能够升起数不尽的心生设法。所以每一个心生设法又里头它又有这个火字，而这火字呢也能够产生新一代的设法。所以这些火字，这个时节生，就是火所升起的火字所升起的设法，我们称为时节生设法。那时节生设法呢，它也有着光明的色彩，所以有赖于这个四禅很深的这个四禅的定力，它能够升起很强的这个光明，这些我们称为智慧之光。那么当以借着这个智慧之光，我们能够去修学，去看到色聚，就是说当我们培养这个世界分别观的时候，我们能够用这个智慧之光看到色聚。而你的心是有这种力量的，如果你不用你的心，不用这股力量，心就会混沌。如果你用你的心如此的运用的话，心强大的心力意志力就会培育起来。那么通过有系统的修学世界分别观，你将能够看到色聚。现在你们要留意听着这个环境，这环境是非常的宁静，非常的好，因为这里很偏僻，很寂静的，所以这是很适合修行这个法来体证什么是苦谛，什么是苦因，什么是寂谛。所以如果你修行这个观禅的话，你能够苦的熄灭，灭谛，你就是涅槃。那你将能够体证过后，你将能够体证这个道智。那道智呢，也具备这个八正道，但是呢，这个八正道是处世间的八正道，所以它是道地。如果你要体证涅槃的话，像这样子，这里这个地方是非常适合的地方。如果你布施这个地方，这是非常好的布施。如果有禅修者在这里用功修行，他们体证涅槃，那是非常的好的。那你会感到快乐，这些成功的禅修者也会感到快乐。所以在佛陀的教法里，像这里这样子啊美好的地方，是对于我们的禅定修行来说是非常重要的。所以你所做的布施也是非常好的。但是如果说你修行成功，你自己体证这个观禅的成就，然后你做一个布施，比如说布施一个库地一个茅棚，那这个布施是更有力量的。为什么呢？因为布施者，作为布施者的你，你的戒很清净，你的定力也很高，然后的智慧也很高，也洞察了这个圣地。因为基于这个戒的清净，你的戒特别的清净，当那个时候呢，它是有这个智慧，也有这个定跟慧在扶持着，所以你的那个戒是更加的殊胜，更加的清净。那佛陀在经里有说，基于这些戒的清净，如果你许愿，你的愿是可以实现的。我在经里说，比丘们，净化自己的心，当一个人他的戒清净的话呢，那他如果许愿，他的愿会得到成就。因为呢，这个他的戒很殊胜，是因为之所以殊胜，是因为他被这个很强很高的定力围绕着。
所以如果你在这样的情形下有这么高层次的戒体，就是有定力围绕着的时候，那你在许愿，那你要许的愿就会得到成就。如果你发愿我要投生做天神，你能够投生做天神，你想投生做梵天神，你能够投生做梵天神。如果你想投生做比丘或者比丘尼，这都是可能的。
Let us start our Dhamma Dhamma. If you have any question, then you can ask.
这是请大家发问，如果你们有什么问题可以发问。
No question? If there is no question, sharing matter. Okay. Yami Ponya. Aswakaya. Mahahotu. Yami Ponya. Nivanasa.Pachyo Hoju Idami Bonya Sabasadana Hajima Isabi Isama Bonya Baga Labandu
Sama